Hey guys, it's Lizzie. So these are five things that they don't tell you at church that I feel like are really, really important concepts for Christians to understand. And from my experience, I've even sometimes believed the opposite or heard the opposite at church. Number one, church is not about you. It's not about fulfilling your needs and what you like and making you happy. I think that in America, at least, it's so capitalistic that we have this consumption mindset that goes into every aspect of our life and how we view it, even our relationships and even Christianity, and I think that's really harmful. And I think that we should think about going to church as a way of pouring into other people and forming those relationships and making other people feel known and loved. If every person going to church on Sunday walked in with the mindset of how can I serve someone, how can I love someone, how can I make someone feel known, then everyone would be taken care of and feel so like family-like and loved. And so we all need to just switch our mindset from what am I getting out of this to how can I love someone else. Number two, there are different ways of interpreting the Bible. So I know that a lot of people view the Bible as this rule book, kind of like this is God's message to humanity, and it is God's message to humanity, but what's really unique about Christianity is that unlike Islam or even Mormonism, where there's like this book and it was kind of just like handed to someone as a revelation from God. What's really unique about Christianity is that our book didn't just come down from heaven or something, but it was compiled over thousands of years by different authors, and there's different genres in it. And so for interpreting the Bible, it's really important to understand the culture and the cultural context. And it's written in ancient languages, and so translating it can sometimes be difficult. Even understanding what certain words meant at that time, that can be difficult. Understanding a culture that has existed so long ago, that's difficult, and it's complicated. There are over 30,000 Protestant denominations in America, and then there's Catholicism and Orthodox Christianity, so there's so many different viewpoints and theologies and doctrines of Christianity. And that doesn't mean that there isn't a truth in each of these areas, it just means that it's really difficult to find, and we shouldn't view people who have come to a different conclusion as stupid or awful or not a Christian. I think it should just make us become humble in what we do believe and really willing to question things, because there's so many intelligent people who believe different things. Number three, doubting your faith is okay. I feel like church really didn't encourage us to question our faith, and I felt even discouraged in it in Bible class growing up. If I brought up a different perspective of a verse that was more unpopular or not according to the church I was at, it was almost like shut down. And instead of looking into it and considering and thinking why it might be true, instead it was just like, this is why we believe this is the right interpretation. We're taught in church and in school, it's even in our education system, to memorize the right answers and to just regurgitate information rather than being taught how to think and how to think through things on our own, and I think that's really harmful and wrong. Even if you're a Christian, sometimes you might question, does God really exist? Was Jesus really resurrected from the dead? Does baptism actually do anything? How can I trust the Gospels if the events in it were written dozens and dozens of years after it actually happened? If evolution is true, does that disprove Christianity? I don't feel God right now emotionally. Does that mean something's wrong with me? Does that mean God doesn't exist? These are so many questions that are really natural to have and to think through, and I think that the worst thing you can do is push that away and act like you are so sure about God existing and about Christianity being true. I think like any emotion or anything you're thinking, you need to express it and think it through and talk about it with someone rather than push it away and act like you're not thinking that. Something else really cool that I found about doubting my faith and like really, really analyzing and thinking through different convictions I have about my faith is that it causes you to trust God more, because within God existing, like there's so many different religions, so many different types of Christians, and so I think that it's really a trust exercise with God. You kind of are just like, okay, I might completely change what I believe, but I trust you and you're gonna be with me through everything. And I think it's beautiful to doubt your faith and to not really know where you're going and to be out of control. I think that's really, really healthy for you. Number four, there are multiple spiritual pathways. So I don't know if you guys have heard of the spiritual pathways quiz, but it's something that I did at Pepperdine last year, and we did it in my small group. You take a quiz and then you get a different score for different things, and some people will be like really high on worship but really low on intellectual, or really high on nature but really low on worship. Everyone's different. Prayer, contemplation, intellectual, worship, nature, serving, justice, or activism, I think it's called. One of my main spiritual pathways is intellectual, and so for me, sermons pour into me spiritually so much, and so does reading my Bible on my own. But if you're not someone who's taking notes during sermons and so stoked to read your Bible every day, that doesn't make you less of a Christian. I think it's really important to stretch yourself in spiritual pathways that you're weaker in or that you haven't developed as much, but that doesn't mean that you need to feel guilty if that's not naturally the way you feel closest to God. What's so important about this is realizing that going to church may not be your spiritual pathway, like what happens in a worship service, in a church service with worship and a sermon. And if you're like that, and if you feel like you don't want to go to church, you don't need to feel guilty for that because you're just built different than other people. And I think that most churches are not very creative in what they do. It's just very like the same every week and very structured. And I think that at bigger churches, they have a lot of different programs where like there might be a prayer walk or small groups or like a ton of service projects. But if they don't have it at your church, go create it. Talk to the leadership of your church and be like, we need to have activities that fit everyone's spiritual pathway. So then get involved in that. And so I don't think you should stop going to church if that isn't your spiritual pathway, because like we talked about at number one, church is not about you. It's about pouring into other people and forming that community. But also, don't feel guilty if you feel like you're getting nothing out of church. It might just be not your spiritual pathway. Number five, Christianity does not bring us answers. The wisdom literature is my favorite part of the Bible. So Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Job, some parts of Psalms. What's really interesting is if you look at a prayer in Psalms or when Job is talking to God, like three quarters of the way through it, and they're questioning God, like seriously questioning him, like why is suffering happening in the world, or like explain this. And instead of answering the question, it's almost like God just gives them peace in not knowing. And so I think that we're not supposed to go to the Bible and find all the answers and be right about things. I think the purpose of the Bible is to teach us about God and to introduce us to God and to help us build a relationship with him. And I think that it's supposed to change our hearts and open our minds more than giving us answers. Ecclesiastes is the book of the Bible that I've read the most, and it talks about the meaning of life. Like it's this exploration of like what is the purpose of the world, and it just goes through all these different things that you could find meaning in. And at the end of the book, it's just like, what? Like it doesn't even have an answer. Like it doesn't even explain what the meaning of life is. The meaning of life book in the Bible, it doesn't even give an answer. And as a Christian, I don't even know what the purpose of this world is or what the meaning of life is. I don't even know why God put us here. I really don't know. Christianity has just made me so aware of my intellectual inadequacy in trying to understand these huge, big questions that involve theology and involve God's interaction with the world. I just barely know anything, and God's given us, each of us, incredible minds, and I think we should use them to try to find truth and to try to think through things, but we shouldn't ever be convinced that we know a lot of anything. So that's everything I wanted to talk about in this video. Those are five things that you don't hear at church that I think we should all think about and understand and agree with. So that church isn't about you, that there are different ways of interpreting the Bible, doubting your faith is okay, there are multiple spiritual pathways, and Christianity does not just bring you all of the answers. Thank you so much for watching, and I love you guys so much. Bye!